Hello, this is going to be a quick introduction to Wade and its visual editor. So the first time you start it, you're going to be asked if you want to store data on your hard drive. You have to say OK, because this is where your projects will be saved. Then you'll be presented with a list of video tutorials to watch. You are watching tutorial number one on this list, so for now I'll just skip tutorials. And this is going to ask me for a name for my new project. And I'll just call it Hello World, and then I click Create Project. Now this has created a new blank project, and it's opened a new blank scene. So let's look at the various parts we have on the screen. On the bottom left corner, we have a list of files that are in our project currently. We can see the same list of files here with bigger icons. So Wade has created some default files to get us started. You can view and edit these files if you want. You just double-click them and you can see and edit the code. But for now, we won't do this, so I'll just right-click here and close the file. On the top left area of the screen, there is a list of objects in our scene, and at the moment this list is empty. I'm going to create a new scene object just by clicking this button here, and this has created a square. So this part of the screen here is our current scene. And I can move this square around. Now this square is actually a scene object, so it's an object that can be made of one or more sprites. And at the moment it's only made of one sprite, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add another sprite to it by clicking this new sprite button. A text sprite is like a sprite, but it contains text. So I'm just going to input some text here. Hello world. And now it's appeared on top of the other square sprite. But we cannot see it very well because it's black on black background. So I'm just going to change the colour to red. And now we can see it much better. Before playing a bit more with it, I'm going to delete my previous sprites by clicking this minus icon here. So essentially we are left with an object that only contains this text sprite. I'm going to make it a bit bigger by changing the font to, say, 32 pixels. And there are lots of things I could change here. But now, just for fun, I'm going to add some white shadows to it. Let's say blur it by 5 and offset it by 2 horizontally and 2 vertically. As you can see, as you type, things change automatically in the scene. Okay, now I've made my Hello World object. I can just press Run. And there it is. This is a little preview of our application. And it doesn't do much at the moment, but it does show Hello World with some nice white shadow. So now I close this, and I can go here to download what I've just done. So I select Download Source Code, and this downloads a zip file that contains a Hello World folder. This contains all the files that I've created, so index and some JavaScript, some CSS files. So basically this is a website that I can open in any browser that just shows Hello World at the moment.